does. It's a little bit late to normal, but you can get things any done any quicker than I have tried. But yeah, today we're filming for 2 hours. So the time when I started will be 9 and 8. Basically, just before 9:20. So it will be finished at 11:20. So we've got 2 hours from now until 11:20. So it's going to be a little big video because obviously I'm going to take 2 days off. Obviously I don't film on a Sunday anyway, but I'm going to take the extra day off on a Monday this upcoming week, because obviously there's too much. I'm going to basically take the Monday off, I'll come back on the Tuesday, and then I'll do a lot of different videos. Obviously this week I'm doing a lot. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Obviously the main stuff, the real train stuff, will come on Thursday. I'll be travelling on the train, but in luck. Of course, Sunday is going to be Slash's birthday. On Friday I'm going climbing with them lots. So and then Monday next week I'll be having a day off from videoing for one day, because obviously with all that going on as well, it's just going to be too knackering doing videos as well. So I'll take one day off next week, and then I'll come back on the Tuesday, and then. But yeah, I basically wanted to fancy doing a 2 hour video because I can cover a lot more things in this episode by doing that. Yeah, it's not going to how I'm going to plan this, but hopefully it will work. But for this 2 hour video, I want to cover quite a lot of things, so that's why I'm doing a 2 hour episode, because I can't remember last time I actually did a 2 hour video. I know it was some time ago, but I thought to have a good 2 hour video covering a few things, and then maybe because as we're doing a 2 hour video, it would be nice to get a few things covered in a 2 hour video as well. Anything that needs to come up, I'll bring it up in the video. Anything that needs to be listed over, then I will do it. So today's video, we're going to do the start part of the video off. We're going to run the trains, mix of freight, passenger, steam engines, diesels, and of course my all-time number one, the Class 43s. I'm not sure to say it gets two of the Class 43s. Obviously the castle is not complete yet, and I haven't got the new units yet, but I will get them. First of all, we're going to look at, we'll start off with the Class 43s, work with the steam, and then work with the radio on the diesels after all that's done. I'll put some freight into to run. So if you wonder what's going on today and what the reason why I'm doing it so long. It's because everyone can have a chance to watch if they want to. And there's no train strikes this week yet so far, so it's quite nice. It means that I can provide trains if I want to. which is pretty good. Because I obviously want to go down somewhere more locally this week. So I will do train stuff. So I might go back down the park. Or studio or something and get a bundle of passionate and freight trains. There we go. So I'll run the First Great Western HST and I'll run the GNR HST. We'll start the video off. The battery needs to change, hopefully it won't need to for at least an hour, and I can chat the other one for another hour, so yeah, let's get these going. The train is ready to go, I think. That's all right. Why did it always stick there? I don't think it... Yeah. Okay, I'll leave that train stop there for the moment and see if we can get the train moving. Train around Virginia going that way. Where is going that way? The first go west and going that way. No, because it was crashed anyway, wouldn't it? So it should stay this way but change direction. So instead of this way, let's go that way. And yeah, for the 2 hours I'll try to get that card in too. Some people will ask me quite well. Well, it's in the living room, I'll grab it in a little bit. Because obviously, the track is not ideal, and it's just a little bit more spaced apart from each other, so we'll have my energy drink, soon. Not right now, but, you know. Oops. Apparently it's going to be alright. I think nothing was over the video. Oh well. This is only a little bottle of EW40. There, I thought, you know, we can just have a little bit of fun to start the video off and the schedule is too running. boxes out of the way. Not really, I'm not going to like the way they want to film this lot. There you go. How long have I filmed for? 2 hours. So, if I can't, it might be quite a long movie. If I can't make it to go on the camera, I can't have to do a little bit on the phone. Maybe do a little live stream with it. It's not the only friends of mine today. I've been running some teenagers a little bit, but I thought one of these two of my friends was up in case, you know, some stuff in the rock and roll or things. But, yeah. Is in operation at the moment. I'm going to have run around as much as you want. And we've got an electricity in the special weapon. We're going to have a gravity castle. We're going to have 57 with the castle set. Since it's going to be up next on the outside line. And we'll give her a couple of the bracket side. But then the power car is not going to be good. Well, that one is good at that. And then the second one.
we'll also move the camera around so you can see it in some operation. Yeah, so we'll just move
Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna have to do a small jump soon for this next part, because the battery's getting low. I know it's only 20 to 10, so I don't want to jump it too early, but I'm gonna have to, aren't I? Just for a little bit. I'll see you guys in a second. Hopefully this will go well.
There we go. Pull up. See if she can manage this one. I mean, if she goes losing, it's probably going out for a while. I mean, because it means she's doing it for something. Here she comes. As I said, I'm going to get a new version of this content. Right, at 11 o'clock, as I say, going to be time for a little bit of neural train for a little bit, because obviously I've got an orbit to cover in this particular video. Apparently at Totnes they have driving days with the trains. I think they're small ones, but I don't think they're the big ones. Actually still going strong. Near 11 o'clock. This is the last time this train run. Oh, I think it was 2021, I think the last one I remember. It was that year. So, yeah, it was a couple of years back now, 3 years ago, I guess. How fast can she move? The weather is fantastic, the weather is really good. Do that too much. Most of them just run out now, so I really had to do that. Top of where I was with that, that could happen. I think overall though, in my entire life, I think the train's always going to be the class 43s over the electrics, to be fair. I mean, they are hybrids, but for electrics, I mean, I like the 85 and the 87, and I'm not a king on the... What was the name of the river? It's never been a big time. I went on it once for my mum and sister a year ago, but it was pretty full. But the only thing I found of it in Pennsylvania, it was actually doing more than 200 miles per hour, more than the limits. And car 33, this time, I've been there to do about 141 back in the day, but I've been in there very, very well to that hour. But if it was pushing it, it could easily do more than 160 if you want to do. So, yeah, it's pretty good if it can bring it up to 160 if they wanted it to upgrade the engine. It's maybe more efficient, but. It's not really needed at the moment. It seemed to be running really well. 2,568 horsepower engines. With a hybrid system attached to them. So I've got all my British Rail diesels and the electric one too, attached together. The only one I can't really connect to the GWR system is this one. One suited for the freight and one suited for the cargo. All these lines are being used in some way for another. But some OCD people think you should join the GWRs with the other GWRs. Well, if I had enough room for them, then I probably would. But I don't. So, that's that. So that's the end of running session. It's near 11 o'clock. If I do cut it a bit short, it's because of the battery reasons, not myself. But I'm going to have to open a drink, at the least. So you're going to have to bear with me. As I said, this will probably take 2 hours to go up. Mine's a other thing, so it's going to go with this video. Next thing I'm going to do is to store all the freight back into the region of siding, so carriages out of the way. I'm steam engine is going to be going down. Well, where the steam is on, that's where the brakes are going to sit. And that's a big bundle. Of course, I'm riding the wheel trains on Thursday. Somewhere locally, not too far away, so obviously because I've got to save money.
So I'm saving up for my container at the moment.
Going to be looking forward to when I get there. It's taking a while to save up for. I'm going to put the freight stuff away now. So we can go back in a bit more. Yard. Put those three. Once I edit these, then I'll start doing the housework, probably after the house and lunch. But obviously I've got to edit these first before I start doing that. Because obviously once these are edited, then they will take a little while to upload. And once they're uploaded, and they go on my thingy, YouTube channel, my train channel, then we can just work on that bit after. Once the editing's done, so that might turn into a 5. The uploading will take probably about 20 minutes, probably. The processing can take anything from 20 minutes to half an hour, depending on the time. But yeah, it could be a long video. By the way, quite a lot of editing, probably, if there's any bits not be in there, but we'll see. I can't say otherwise at this moment in time, so I've checked all through with my editing software. Now the only breaks in the same section. It's good, because it means one part of the layout is all for the freight. The other part of the yard is going to be for the passenger, and then you've got all the house stuff on the far side. For like, you've got the old rail, mail, luggage, car, and then you've got the parcels, bikes, letters, and a variety of other bits and rail, mail stuff. And of course there's, I would like to get the Virgin HST set and the MDR, but the InterCity is the next one I'm aiming to get. The last couple of carriages, right, I'm going to stick that into the side next to it. Now we've done it red in the camcorder, so 1101. We've done 1101, that's pretty good. If it cuts, then I'm not going to be too bothered. You know, this is only another 15 minutes. If I'm going to edit the videos. I'm not going to go into doing loads of 2-hour videos. Just do one here and there. So like the doll video I'll be doing. Might be filming 2 hours and then I might be covering a 15 minute video each episode of the video of the companion dog. But yeah, I'll show the next video, I'll show the next stuff. I'll probably show the next part of the work I'm going to get done with the photos so I can get up and running for the summer, this summer.
not next year, because next year I'll probably be doing loads of hoodies T-Day with the GWR Castle, and then there'll be the First Great Western and the GNR HST. There's going to be quite a few of them. And next year I might get to the In-City one. And the cross country as well. Right, let's decouple. The train will be one side. I don't have as high interest on the, so to speak, so I'm not as big of interest on the Pennsylvania as much as the Castle of Greece. But, I mean, with the Pennsylvania, the original Pennsylvania livery, it did look smart in its colours, but it did kind of ruin by the taste of the people. Well, the taste of the livery didn't work as well. I think it worked better in the Class 43 set, in the Virgin livery. I think that looked better than the actual Pennsylvania Tilton type, which doesn't look near as... I think the Class 43 and... the Class 43 set in the Virgin livery looks smarter than it does in the Pennsylvania. That's just in my opinion, though. Everyone has their own taste, but it looks nicer to them. But for me, I think the HST Virgin livery looks better. Yes, it doesn't have the tilting thing, so it doesn't tilt much higher. It does tilt, but it's not a lot. It's like a small radius of amount tilting with the train. So you can go around that radius at a comfortable speed, doing like 60, 70 miles an hour. But you're doing that sort of tilting with the HST of 125 or 141, there's very few of them, then you will see some problems. Right, this part is going to be just cleaning up the railway for now. If it does die, I do apologise, but the batteries in both of them are red. So, if one dies, I'll check on the other one for like a short time, and then finish it off, edit, and upload it. But it's only a few minutes now. Hey Siri, how long is it until 11:15? How long is it until 11:15 this morning? How long is it until 11:15? 10 minutes. Only got 10 minutes. Can the battery hold out for 10 minutes? It's a bit dodgy, isn't it? But we'll clean up. We'll clean up the lounge a bit, so we can kind of get things organised, ready for tomorrow's review. I don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. Or what I've got planned for. But I think the train will look interesting with a variety of different liveries. For this old 47, I'm not quite sure how that system's going to work. I doubt it runs anyway, because I have tried it before. Even with the spring in it, it just doesn't work. There's a flicker of light, and then it goes... So, yeah, there's nothing there. I couldn't get a new model this time. But it did have a lit up headlamp, but it didn't really have much else. So, maybe it's worth getting a quality. Yeah,
mess there. I'm just going to clean out all the messes left from this, basically this, what's left of the layout. The mess needs to be cleaned up, and I can do this properly. Because right now it looks kind of messy. The glue marks are where the platform used to sit, which is why I'm on the far side, that's why the platform is set here. Obviously the platform now is going to be, I'm going to have curved points on it. So the heritage line will come out here, and then it'll just go in again. It had a couple of points on the heritage line, so it's going to be a variety of different things, but it's all being worked on at the moment. So, bear with me. It's not easy to work me all of it, but 8 minutes to go. I'm going to swap it over for the last bit of the video and see how we get on. So you guys bear with me, just for a second. Fill in the number, friend. So yeah, I'll be filming until 11:15 and I'm going to be basically finishing at 11:15. I know it's late for me because obviously I usually film for an hour, but I want to do a little bit longer videos from time to time, but not regularly, if you see what I mean. So yeah, it's going to be a 2-hour video for today. You're going to see freight, you're going to see steam engines, you're going to see diesels, you're going to see non-electric running through on this railway. It's going to be a variety of little bits and pieces. You will see today's video, which you don't often see in an hour. So it's going to be quite a lot there for you to see. Off you go, so the train. As you get through it, for the most part, and there would be the back of the train, just there. That one? No, it is. Right, eeny, miny, moe. I'm trying to decide what train to pull the freight start with. 25? I mean, the steam engine might be a challenge. You could go for a steam engine. Let's give it a try. I mean, what harm is it going to give it a try to pull a steam engine pulling cargo? Obviously it wouldn't look accurate Monday, but, you know, how can I still do pull wagons? occasionally. Not as often as they used to, but they do occasionally, and they've been shut around certain times of countries in Ireland. They occasionally move around to form over the more to do with this going for them, but it's hardly ever. But I thought, you know, it'd be nice to see, you know, a tank locomotive in one of my favourite videos, and a tank locomotive in VR Black. For a long period of time, just for a short time running the train. Then we'll swap it over to a diesel, because that's what modern network rail tends to use a lot of the time when you put in the cargo, but or hybrids, generally diesel hybrid systems they often pull. But yep, that's basically what trains do. But back in the 60s and the 70s, they would have pulled steam engines, put in cargo, and probably in some countries still do. Which is quite incredible, really, but I doubt this sort of thing will pull anything this size. It's trying, but it's not going anywhere. It's tiny, it's too lightweight. That's good for you to put in one carriage, completely clean track, and then put away all the wagons, so that's the sort of thing it's good for. Now we're going to have the little bit of a battered Class 57 put in the next freight. Obviously being the freight is more good for that. And then we're going to have steam engines put in the this train, the deforming carriages. So they're going to be double heading, or maybe triple, depending on how long the train's going to be. So I need to find a GWR Castle, find a coupling for it. And of course the 33's got it. So what I might do is swap the train over for doing this. Is to let the steam engines put in the old British Rail. The old British Rail stuff. In the old Class 47 put in it. Obviously the 47s, 57s, 25s and all that were designed for old freight at one time. Way back in the day, back in the 60s. From the 70s really pulling lots of this. They did get replaced by 66s, 59s and the class 68s, new ones that are coming out. Obviously the 66s are pretty damn heavy in real life. They're heavier than the most standard 66s are, I think. They've got new hybrid systems in them. They've got potentially for the third rail options, I think, from them. I think that's okay. But, yeah, it's crazy to think there's trains out there can put in options for third rail diesels now. Which I think there should be an option for most trains in the castles. They can, if they put pickup shoes on the castles, then they have the option of using diesel as third rail. So, I think they have those shoes on and they can try and see it as well. They've got a trial and see what happens, but because you don't know if it's going to work or not unless you try it first. And it'll give you an idea if it's likely to work in those particular trains, and they can keep them going for a little bit longer, like 50 years or something. But they've got some upgrades to them to make them last a little bit longer. Which for me, I think it would be a brilliant idea if they did have a system like that for those particular type of trains. That way they can run as long as possible. There we go, we're going to swap the battery over. I might have to film the last bit of this video on my phone, because I have a pen. That's the end of it, I'm still having. So yeah, I'm going to be
too long. We've got half an hour till 11 o'clock, and then we've got another 10, 15 minutes after that. That's a cool sound. I tried that with any train when you go there and some joint in the track, and it's a big track sound. Right. Get this one going. I could do a live stream for the next video. I'm going to be doing a live stream on the Video Game Plays channel. I've got my old gaming channel back up. I've got it all sort organised. It took me a while to find the code for it to be able to use it again. Pretty awesome, right? So, I might do a Video Game Plays for it tomorrow. In the morning, and then obviously I'll do a companion doll video, which will be once I've got my companion doll, I'll do a video on that. I know I keep growing, I've got such me. I've got more plans for this channel as well this year as well. I've got a lot more plans this year with the main lines and the heritage lines and a lot more things going with that. And there will be the unboxing with a new train. Probably to do with the title, new one. I'm deciding which train to get yet. I'm deciding to get King Country Castle or maybe one of the different ones. But it's been quite well for the freight, so we'll keep the 47 going for a little bit longer, and then we'll do 57. And then what I'll do towards the end of the video at 11 o'clock, I will keep the train going and maybe keep them slow. Something. pretty cool, doesn't it? It sounds awesome. But I want to get more wagons. At some point, yeah, maybe, but right now, I'm not too bothered right now because obviously I'm going to get everything sorted at the moment. Right, on my lap, the 6.7 and a little bit. So let's stop it there and get the other freight done. Not the other freight train, which is going to be the 58 EWS, class 58 by Haldon. I think it's the best example of the 58. Personally, if you would like the 58s, I highly recommend getting the 58 by Haldon. They're the best ones. Everyone's smooth too, so you haven't got any problems with that. The one's really smooth, so. Honestly, I don't have a modern, you know, I haven't got a 66 thing in hand or any 47 thing, but GM 58 is last year's model. I might not set an hand thing, but I'm just going to just because of one of the things that's come undone. There we go. Quite nice. The I think I can have a little bit of fun with it. I'll get one right away. So, I'm going to be changing up the battery in a moment. one's almost died. Had it on red yet. 10.1. Doing well at the moment.
We've been rated I've done for a while. The longest one I've done. So it's got a fair while. Let's get the other one done.
Give me a pen, Mike. Just pushing the car dead down there. Get that down flat. There we go. What about the Pembrolino? Oh, the Pembrolino. What about this thing? Not quite, it doesn't run very much because of the scope thing. But I do occasionally put it out to see if it can be run. As I said, she's not quite the, she's not a big runner, as not for some of the others, but I will give her a try for you guys, so, you know, that's a bad evening with her, because I don't know, comment. I do like the Pembrolino, I did mention it when I was little, which took the train I was on when I was little, I did travel in it, it wasn't the Halston one, it was the original, Pembrolino, it's Class 380, I think it was originally Class 380, but I don't know. Well, obviously Voyager was originally a burden train going at one time as well, but is it Avanti or something? It's changed now. I think it's called Avanti. But yeah, the version living on the Pembrolino is now for Avanti, I think. It's got been coloured. And of course, you've got the back train and coupling. And you can see the size of this train, it's quite big. It takes quite a lot of length of the train up. So what I'm going to do is stop the train in a minute and we'll do pull the Pembrolino on. So what it's worth for a period of time. So yeah. Take the cargo off. Put those three carriages off. I don't know if I'm going to get to 11:30 or not because the batteries might not be strong enough to hold them out for that longer period of time. But we'll see. Because I mean the video might not go up until 5 p.m. but if you want it, it might go up that late. But we'll see. We'll see how long it takes to get up. But yeah, it might take 2 hours. Or probably 5, depending on how big it is. But I'm going to send this odd 1-2 hour video for you so you can guys enjoy the trains for the most part. I'm going to have to put the power into the train. I'm going to put the power car last on, because obviously the power car one's going to move. So I'd rather not do power car first. Yeah, that coupling did come off. But it might do at some point. Okay, it might not completely accurate for its time, but what I might do then instead, I might use some super glue. I thought I was going to put the fender on, but I'm still going to. I might put the power car on and the training car. Because there's a three car set instead of the two extra, well, the one extra carriage. So you can just see how well she is and how she's going to couple up to this electric part of the train instead of the buffet car. It will be edited, uploaded, as I said, and in the meantime while that's doing all that, I'll probably get some housework done, get it tidied and whatnot, and then have some spotted of lunch and whatnot, have tea and whatnot. How fast is the 25 go fast? How fast did the panel running over? You know, I think they were about 65. I think that probably was correct, but some of you who are more advanced train enthusiasts, you can tell me that is true. Or not. I could be completely wrong in my guessing, but I think some did take on that expansion right now. Very few of them did, but some did. But I think most of them did about 65, I think, for the most part. So, I think that's what it is. I could be wrong. But of course we had the flying Scotsman who did 100 miles an hour. Now she will move. And we can't lock her up. You can hear the engine going. Comes. It's on a special train as well, so I hope you do well with it. There's only one carriage in the train car, I think it's TWR Castle. Suits quite well between the two of them. In the colours of the very old GWRs were brighter. They're more a darker blue colour now than what they used to be like. I don't know why they changed the GWR to a different colour type of green. Maybe it was because it was a more advanced system or something for the unit, I don't know. Oh, and then I think it's a Scania, I think, or is it Kenya? I can't remember. Thank you. Right. I am going to mix this train up a little bit after the next lap. Because this train's not quite happy doing this. But, I'm going to put it with a different train after I've done some of the two other steam engines running on the fly. Get one lap in with the this one. One whole lap in. And we'll just go around one more time and then sort of stop a just fast camera. Where's that train? Okay. Yeah, this train is far from perfect. Yeah. Right, it's going to get a little bit odd from this point because I don't have many GWR sets. The next set will be the castle, the new castle, the train with a few characters. You've got a little hand line for this line, but which would be awesome, but time being, I mean, there's a locomotive. The cheap one I got. I'm going to mix this up. So the console, so this one is 43005, and she sits in the. I'm going to change the train up actually. I'm going to take the console carriage off and sit her in the siding where she's supposed to sit with her next to other friends of the HST family with the units, and of course we've got the training car which is right at the back. And we've got 25 of these swapping over too, which is going to be over the one of the other British Rail trains. I'm not totally sure what other British Rail train I've got except for this little shunter, which will run for a short time while just connecting to her. I mean, those two will be right for a short time together. As long as they're running for a couple of laps, I think they will be right for it. Because I'm in the CAD's OTD, you know, honestly I have got one more bit that I'm trying to attend to for the end of the video. I'm going to take the CAD out of this one, so she can use it, the last bit of the train that she's going to be using. So we've got the 33, quite an album. Right, for the outside line, I'm thinking cargo. So there isn't, and I'm thinking kind of good. So obviously there's a couple of items on almost an empty siding, but not quite. So what I'm going to do, if I can do it, I'll bring her out bit by bit, and I'm going to use the door up, get the cargo in, and that'll be longer than 57, but probably more to do with 58, maybe. Yeah, steam engine. I'll run to my steam engine a little bit. Obviously we've got the frame bombing carriages still to where they from the video as well. Because it's so old, it's still running as strong as it is for that moment. The trend's more designed for high speed. And the trends are really only designed to get in terms of that car. Yeah, this is about this train next to it. Very unsmooth. It's not very smooth at all. I mean, that would be like basically what a pacer would be like. Pushing and shoving it around. If you left to right, that's what the train will be like. It will literally be like being thrown around at the very extreme. Half a battery. Let's get the last British Rail carriage, or last British Rail train I own. I can't remember where I put the coupling for it. I thought I was sticking it from the camera, didn't I? Maybe I didn't. Maybe it's somewhere. Can't see it anywhere. So annoying. So, because for the last couple of minutes, I'm putting the other battery in. Because it's the only way to get it done. I know this is not fully charged, it's telling me porkies with the camcorder, but I'm just going to tidy up for the next couple of minutes, because basically I got, it's nearly 10 past now. So to end this video off, hope you guys enjoyed the running session. I haven't done any scenery today or anything much in that area. But I'm just going to do some tidying up now and basically put things away, put things there where they're supposed to be put. You'll see some more HSD running station. Not tomorrow, I'm going to do some video gameplay tomorrow, I think. So, if you want to follow me on my original gaming channel, go and follow me on there. I'm going to be doing that with the Xbox videos. And if I can get the original original PS4 working, then I can work with Resident Evil series, or Last of Us, both of the types, and Days Gone, and Senoska, Blood Zero, and the original Senoska, and GTA 5. Sort of all these games that can be played with, and Outlast 2, and there's going to be Iron Man, eventually. So yeah, I'm just going to clean all this up and get rid of the things that don't need to be needed. Tracks. Everywhere. Like that. This whole controller is just for testing the basic and seeing the engine still work on some of the older units, but some do work fine. Others a bit past the best. So yeah, that needs to be moved. I think this needs to be moved and out of the way for the time being. The energy drink is the one I'm drinking. So yeah, I only can do so much in the last 10 minutes. Quarter past now. Well, nearly. 3 minutes. Put that away. Put the towel to one side. Another coupling system. The tunnel. Sorted. But I'm going to try to get the bullies fixed today if I've got time. I'll just get in there halfway down. Probably going for a walk as well, so. I need a short radius curve to come around here. Pull out the train and then one going in there. I'm losing my voice today. The train setup was pretty awesome. Right, I think that's the best I can do for now. I'll do the rest later. We're about to finish the video. 2 more minutes left. My new companion doll, I'm going to be getting. I'm going to talk more about that actually on my companion doll on my companion doll YouTube channel, which I'm going to be posting when it turns up. I will give you some updates when I buy it, and I'll let you know how long it's going to take. But then I'll basically be waiting for her to when she turns up. Not long to go before I buy her. And then I've just got the process to roll her up, maintain her, we'll give her a clean, get some clean clothing for her and get some things washed. And I need to get some white clothing for her too. So, yeah. 1 minute to go. That's it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed the 2 hours. Maybe 2.5 if I left it to 11:30, but I'm not. 11:15 is what I'm going for, so it's 11:15, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, give it a like, comment and subscribe to the channel. Look forward to the video gameplay channel. I'm going to be doing another video gameplay tomorrow. Not totally sure what I'm going to play as yet. Maybe I'll return to the old Minecraft on the Xbox, because I haven't got a PS4 working at the moment, because it's got some issues. And then we'll come back to the Modern stuff, maybe probably Saturday. So we'll give a couple of days away from the Modern stuff, and then at least till Thursday, because obviously I'm doing the main line on Thursday. Then, yeah. We might see what we can do. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys on Thursday on this channel. Maybe Wednesday. We'll see. I'll see you guys then. Have a great day. Peace out. Okay, we're back for the 2 hours. So 11:15 is when we're finished.
this morning. She's more consistent, but that point still slows her down. I apologise for those that people might want to see from the build. Well, I'm glad to say that I'm going to be further filled in April, which is only next month. So I'm going to be at Exeter next month because the Flying Scotsman coming down at the end of the April, so that'll be pretty awesome. And of course there's the summer months with, you know, all the hours. Plug in the GWR castle, but it's not going to be the normal way of doing the castle. It's going to be train car the HST with the train car of the, well, the train car of the HST, the non-powered one. This one will be the 5070 WR castle. One of the very aero you see attached to the main train. But I'm sure on occasion when it did happen, if the castle or something broke down, they would have to pull out the GWR 57, aka basically the the 57's up next. I'm just going to see how she gets on with this train. It's only a small train at the moment because obviously I only got one carriage for this train and I haven't got the two new power units for the castle, so of course, you know, I will get the new one. I'll get one at the end of the summer. I get another carriage, there'll be another carriage here. But there's only the one.
But we'll try to see if we can try and recreate the original set at Castle Wood.
Yeah, Germany would have.
I'm going to take it off the tripod and try to connect to the train. Pop it there. contract line's going to be carrying a writer, a frame up, and it's going to be putting my cargo on the outside line as well today, as well as packing up, some updates to the layout. I kind of like it, but it's going to be happening for a time. Carries on. And let her run around a little bit more, then
and we're going to drop her over to
send the other trains a little bit. So there might be no filming for me on Monday next week, but I certainly will do some on Tuesday. And hopefully we've done it sorted. Get the user 57 in the house. It's kind of temporary until I get the new car sorted and just do that. Yeah, this 57 does like smooth metal. Doesn't like anything all over the place. And also these carriages will be changed to a different livery at some point. I haven't done it yet. But I will. I'm not sure what kind of livery. The 10-2 by 5. Small passenger train with first class, it's going to follow a passenger train of British Rail.
what the pads are.
Okay.
do 2 more laps of each, and then we'll swap them over again. Last lap for the H2, and then last lap now for Tanya. And the Brickville H7. Once you next come down, then I'll stop her, and then we'll swap the train over again. I'll go into the Tanya. She just reached that one. Once she comes down again, I'll stop her. Right. I'm going to take off the 87 first and then the Tanya. And she's off. Let's have a little bit more slower one. Here. Looking off 25, British Rail. Blue and yellow. Obviously they're wearing blue and grey too. I ought to mention that, but it's also in blue and grey, blue and yellow. I think they only mainly did blue and yellow and blue and grey ones. They never really get aimed at in other ones. As far as I'm aware of. When she gets past the sometimes you can run for quite a high speed. Here comes the back train in. Right, we put the panny away and we put the 87 away. Bit of rail stuff. I'm going to have them in a particular order as well, because that way I can have all the British Rail stuff mixed in, well not mixed together, but they're basically going to be combined in each other, so to speak. Between all the British Rail stuff will sit in with the British Rail, and all the non-British Rail ones will go separately. Say like the Castle, GWR, all the GWR. Apart from the Castle sets, HSTs and whatnot, all those can be. If it's a Castle, then it can be used in a variety of different forms. Once I've done my filming this morning, I'm going to be editing it, uploading it for you guys. So 11:15 is when I finished filming this morning. Then, once I've done my filming, it will be edited.
There's no train due here for another 20 minutes.
Yes, definitely a voyager.
I could tell by the nose.